Hello guys, welcome to my next class. The topic is indeterminate forms. Now I'm going to solve problems on the board. Before going to that, first I'm going to discuss what's an indeterminate form, what's a use to study for indeterminate form, where they're going to use indeterminate form. Most of the students, they're going to confuse for this. Actually, indeterminate form is once you write the given function, say for example, I'm going to write in the left right extreme corner. Observe carefully now. The given function, say for example, say limit as say x tends to a, the function f of x divided by g of x. This function, suppose we get f of a divided by g of a. Now, this function, suppose corresponding the limit as x tends to a, either function is not equal to finite or not equal to infinite value. Then we say that the given function corresponding the limit is takes which one? Indeterminate form. Now, but sometimes we get infinity. Some students, they feel this is also indeterminate form. Keep in mind, the given function corresponding the limit is not, can't write any finite or infinite value, finite or infinite value of the limit. Then we say that the given function in the corresponding the limit takes which form? Indeterminate form. Say, for example, limit as x tends to a, the function f of x over g of x is of the form what we get actually f of a divided by g of a. So, f of a, suppose as x tends to a, f of x is infinity, this is also infinity. Infinity by infinity, can't write, this must be equal to infinite or no, can't write is a finite value. Why? Because what's the value of the infinity is 1 by 0. Therefore, keep in mind, when we consider the given function corresponding limit is takes, it's not equal to finite or infinite value, then we say that the corresponding function in the corresponding the limit is takes an indeterminate form. Now here, before moving to the indeterminate form in depth, why you need to study for indeterminate form? Indeterminate form is one of the tool or one of the method to find out the value of the limit whenever it's not possible to find out the value of the limit is directly. Once you apply the limit in the numerator, apply the limit in the denominator, or apply the limit in the first term and the second term, you can't, even though it's a finite value of the limit, you can't find out the limit. In such cases, we go for indeterminate form method to find out the value of the limit. Now, indeterminate form means the expression corresponding the limit is not equal to finite or infinite value, then we treat it the corresponding the forms are nothing but indeterminate form. Now, I mentioned here, the indeterminate forms are nothing but it takes in the form of 0 by 0. Because 0 by 0, you can't write is equal to 0, is not equal to infinity, whatever may be. You can't write any finite or infinite value. Therefore, 0 by 0 is one of the indeterminate form. Infinity by infinity is a non-zero value, but it's not a finite value. Infinity is nothing but 1 by 0. Therefore, once you substitute the value of infinity, 1 by 0 by 1 by 0, it takes which form actually? 0 by 0. You already know that 0 by 0 is an indeterminate form. But you already know that 0 into non-zero value is nothing but 0 except infinity. Why? Because infinity is nothing but 1 by 0. Infinity is nothing but 1 by 0. Multiply that, we get 0 by 0. Therefore, even though what you know the concept, 0 into non-zero value is 0 except infinity because infinity is 1 by 0. And similarly, infinity minus infinity. Yeah, most of the students are telling that a minus a is 0. Except infinity minus infinity. Because infinity is 1 by 0, 1 by 0, simplify that, we get is in the form of 0 by 0 only. Now, 1 to the power of any non-zero value, we get 1, except infinity, because once you take log, suppose that y is equal to 1 to the power of infinity, once you take log, what we get log y is equal to log of 1 to the power of infinity. What is log of a power of m? M log a, m infinity into log 1. What is log 1 base e is 0. What we get actually? Infinity to 0. But you already know that infinity 0 is an indeterminate form. Therefore, even though 1 to the power of non-zero value except infinity, now we say that is a 1, but 1 to the power of infinity is an indeterminate form, Why? Because once you take log, simplify that, we get which one? Infinity into 0. Next, 0 to the power of infinity. 0 to the power of infinity. Again, I have to take log. Log 0 into infinity. Okay. You know, the this also can't take any finite or infinite value. Therefore, this also one of the indeterminate form. Similarly, infinity to the power of 0. Now, once you take log, what we get? 0 into log infinity. Then log infinity is infinity, then 0 into infinity is an indeterminate form. Therefore, in all cases, what I written on the, my slide, in all the cases, we treated the corresponding function in the corresponding limit. Suppose you take any one of these forms, you treated as an indeterminate form. Indeterminate form means, suppose the given function corresponding the limit, you can't write equal to finite or infinite value, we treated the corresponding function in the corresponding limit takes which form? Indeterminate form. Therefore, generally, what are the indeterminate form occur in the problem I mentioned here? What are the forms? 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, infinity 0 into infinity, infinity minus infinity, 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity to the power of 0. In all the cases, yeah. Now, you see, now I'm going to skip this. Yeah, I'm going to explain on the plain board the rest of the thing. Okay. Okay, fine. Yeah. Now, before I'm going to explain the rest of the thing on the board, I'm going to write the headline of the topic. What's the headline of the topic? Indeterminate form. Yeah, I think it's clear we get idea what's the meaning of indeterminate forms. Now, where they're going to use? Whenever the given function corresponding the limit, you can't find out directly finite value or infinite value. In such cases, we treated the given function in the corresponding limit takes which form? Indeterminate form. Now, suppose the function in the form of indeterminate form, how to find out the value of the given function, either maybe finite or infinite value? There we are using one of the rule is nothing but L'Hospital's rules. Yeah, what is, if you want to go for L'Hospital rule, keep in mind you can't go for all the form of indeterminate form L'Hospital rule. You already know that what are the different type of, what about that indeterminate form? What are the different forms? 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, 0 into infinity, infinity minus infinity, and then 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0. These are the indeterminate form. In all the cases, you can't write any finite or infinite value. Now, how to find out the value of finite or infinite value by using L'Hospital rule? The first condition, if you want to go for the L'Hospital rule, it must be follow some condition. The first condition, the given function, corresponding the limit, say limit as extends to a, f of x dx, it must be takes any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. It must be take any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then we say, then it's possible I to go for L'Hospital rule. If we want to go for L'Hospital rule, for the given function in the corresponding the limit, it must be take either any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. This is our first step. Suppose the given function, the corresponding the limit is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, directly fine. Suppose it's not in that form, first you have to express the given function corresponding the limit either in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Once you convert that form, next we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. Applying the L'Hospital rule means first you find out the first derivative of the numerator and denominator separately. Don't apply quotient rule. Keep in mind, you have to differentiate both numerator and denominator separately and individually. Suppose the numerator having is a product of two functions. There you have to go for product rule. Now, this is once you find out the derivative of the numerator and denominator once individually, the meaning is we are applied once L'Hospital rule. Once you apply the L'Hospital rule, after that, I to verify what happened the corresponding limit. What happened f dash of a over g dash of a. Again, it takes in the form of infinity by infinity or 0 by 0, then again we are going to apply L'Hospital rule. Again we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule means, again I have to differentiate next derivative of the numerator and denominator separately or individually. After that, again I have to verify what happens second derivative of the function at x is equal to a, at x is also denominator. Again it takes in the form of infinity by infinity or 0 by 0, then again we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. Again we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule means what? Again I have to differentiate both numerator and denominator separately. Means third derivative of the numerator divided by third derivative of the denominator. Continue this process until we get the value of the limit must be finite or infinite. Then we are going to stop that applying the L'Hospital rule, and then we have to write the value of the limit is what we get, finite or infinite, from the which rule? L'Hospital rule. Keep in mind, if you want to go for L'Hospital rule, what is our first step? And to convert each the present function in the corresponding the limit, either is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then apply once L'Hospital rule. Before going to apply this rule, must one should have to write by applying L'Hospital rule. Once you write the L'Hospital rule, then verify what happened in the corresponding limit. Suppose this takes in the form of infinity by infinity or 0 by 0, again we are going to apply L'Hospital rule. Continue this process until reach takes finite or infinite value. Then we have to write that is the value of the given function in the corresponding limit. But one thing, beginning the given function corresponding the limit takes 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, after you find out the first derivative, you can't expecting again is in the form of infinity by infinity or 0 by 0. Sometimes we get infinity minus infinity divided by 0. It's an indeterminate form, but you can't apply immediately next step of L'Hospital rule. Keep in mind, if you want to apply the L'Hospital rule, first you observe present function in the corresponding the limit. It must be takes any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then only we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. In some textbook, even though it states in the after the second step of applied L'Hospital rule, we get takes infinity minus infinity divided by 0. In spite of that, simply they are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. But is against the concept of L'Hospital rule. Even though apply, we get answer. Answer is not important. The method also steps also very, very important. Our L'Hospital rule says, if you want to apply this rule, it the given function corresponding limit, it must be takes any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Therefore, before moving to the applying the L'Hospital rule for each and every step, first you have to verify present function corresponding the limit either is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then only we have to proceed. Otherwise, you can't proceed. How to do it? Again, I have to simplify. Try to express other indeterminate form is of the form 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then after that only we have to apply what actually L'Hospital rule. Applying the L'Hospital rule means finding the derivative of the numerator and denominator separately or individually. Then suppose either in the numerator or in the denominator having a product of two functions, apply the product rule and then you have to find out the value. But don't combine in both numerator and denominator, don't apply the quotient rule. This is the beauty of L'Hospital rule. This is a way I apply the L'Hospital rule to find out the value of the limit either may be finite or infinite value. The next question arises, suppose the given function takes in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, there is no problem, directly we are going to applying what? L'Hospital rule. But other indeterminate form, 0 into infinity, is an indeterminate form, but you can't apply the L'Hospital rule, LH rule. You can't apply. How to apply? First, you have to convert this 0 into infinity is in the form of 0 by 0. How to convert? Observe product of two functions. Which function is a simple function? Take it in the denominator. Either you convert 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. This is the way I have to convert 0 into infinity is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Observe product of two functions. Which one is simple? You take it as in the denominator. Immediately we take convert in which form? 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Suppose the given function is in the form of, but I'm going to do advise the student, suppose is in the form of 0 into infinity. Suppose the product of one of the function is involving tan, cot, cosecant. Better you take that function in the denominator. I to take tan in the denominator, you know what's the reciprocal of tan, what's the reciprocal of cot, what's the reciprocal of secant, what's the reciprocal of cosecant. Then because finding the derivative of cosecant, easy to find out derivative of sine. Finding a derivative of secant, take the reciprocal, that becomes cos, easy to find out derivative of cos. That function better I to take in the denominator. Next, suppose this is the one form. Suppose the given function corresponding the limit is takes in the form of infinity minus infinity. How to convert in the form of 0 by 0? In that case, now I have to take LCM. Before going to take LCM, suppose having any cosecant function, same cosecant, secant, cosecant, secant, cot, sine, better I express in terms of sine. Sine, this is cos, tan can be written as sine by cos, and then cot can be written as cos by sine. Once you express in terms of sine or cos, and then you take LCM. Because finding derivative of cos and sine is very easy compared to tan or cot or secant or cosecant. Then you take LCM, immediately takes in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Okay. You must be remember these tips, then easy to solve the problems using L'Hospital rule to find out the value of the limit. Okay. The third form is nothing but all power form, 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0. In all three forms, whenever having a power, and also sometimes 0 to the power of 0 also. In all forms, sometimes infinity to the power of, you see, 0 to the power of 0. In all forms, whenever having indeterminate form, having a power, we can't convert directly. It's in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. First, you have to remove the power. How to remove the power? First, you take some new variable, say y must be equal to the given limit, given function corresponding to the limit, say is in the form of 1 to the power of infinity. First you take log. Once you take log, this power becomes product. For example, the given function states in the form of 1 to the power of infinity. Once you take log, what happens? Infinity into log 1. What is log 1 value? Keep in mind in the mathematics, log. What's a base? Base is e. Therefore, log 1 base is 0. Therefore, what we get actually? Infinity into 0. You already know that infinity to 0 is an indeterminate form. How to convert also just few minutes before I explain. Take product of one of the function in the denominator. Before going to take product of any one of the function, observe carefully whether having tan, cot, secant, and cosecant, better to take that function in the denominator. Immediately we get is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, and then you proceed to find out the value of the limit. That gives us the value of log y, the value of log y. At the end, remove the log. How to remove the log? Now you already know that e power of log of the function is nothing but function itself. Therefore, take log, e power of log of y is nothing but y. Our given function is y. Therefore, at the end, I have to remove the log. Remove the log means take exponential on both sides. E power of log of f of x is f of x. Then that gives rise our the value of the given function in the corresponding limit. Suppose is in the form of 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0, 0 to the power of 0. Now, I think it's clear. Once we get these concept picture clearly, the rest of thing is very, very easy. Now, before I'm going to wind up this class, I'm going to recall that what are things I discussed just now. Indeterminate forms. What is the indeterminate form? When we consider the given function is indeterminate form, suppose the given function in the corresponding limit is not in the form of, you don't get a finite or infinite value. We treat that corresponding forms are nothing but indeterminate forms. what are the standard indeterminate forms are 0 by 0, infinity by infinity, 0 into infinity, infinity minus infinity, 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, and infinity power of 0. In all the cases, you can't write any finite or infinite value. How to find out the value of the limit you in the function corresponding the limit takes any one of the indeterminate form? You can't find out directly without using L'Hospital rule. What is our L'Hospital rule? If you want to go for L'Hospital rule, I'm going to explain only the statement. The proof is not included. Now, the L'Hospital rule says, now the given function, the corresponding limit, it must be take either any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Once you're in that form, then we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. Applying the L'Hospital rule means finding the first derivative of the numerator and denominator separately or individually. Then once you find out the first derivative, then we say we apply once L'Hospital rule. After once you apply the L'Hospital rule, verify the corresponding limit, what we get. Suppose we get a finite value. Now we have to say this is a value. Suppose it's not a finite value, observe states which form. Suppose after the first derivative for both numerator denominator, either is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, then again I go for, again we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule. Again we are going to apply the L'Hospital rule means find out the second derivative of the numerator and denominator separately or individually. Then again I verify. Continue this process to apply the finding the derivative of the numerator and denominator individually or separately until reach the finite or infinite value of the given function in the corresponding limit. Then we are going to stop. Then we say that this is the value of the limit. Keep in mind, beginning the function is take 0 by 0 and infinity by infinity. We can't expecting after once you apply the L'Hospital rule, again we get is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. For example, some cases we get infinity minus infinity by 0. It's an indeterminate form, but you can't apply the L'Hospital rule. Keep in mind, before going to apply the L'Hospital rule, present function in the corresponding limit must be takes any one of the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Then only is possible to apply the L'Hospital rule. If the L'Hospital rule says, if f of x and g of x is take 0 as extends to a, 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, then limit as extends to a, f of x over g of x can be written as f dash of a, f dash of a divided by g dash of b. This is our L'Hospital rule. Question is arise, the given function is corresponding the limit is take 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, fine. Directly we are going to consider L'Hospital rule. Other form, 0 into infinity is other form. How to proceed? We have to take product of one of the functions. The denominator is takes in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, and then you continue. Then you have to operate the L'Hospital rule. While taking product of one of the functions in the denominator, observe carefully. Suppose any one of the function, either any one of the function having tan, cot, cosecant, or secant, better you take that function in the denominator. Yeah, then why we are insist to take like that? Instead of finding derivative of cosecant, secant, finding derivative of sine and cos is very easy. That's why I'm going to insist the student to better you take that function in the denominator. Then automatically it takes in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Suppose the given function in the corresponding limit takes in the form of minus infinity to minus infinity. In that case, I have to take LCM. Why? Before going to take LCM, suppose any one of the term having tan, cot, cosecant or secant, first you have to express in terms of sine or cos. And then you take LCM. Then you automatically takes any one of these two forms. Then you proceed to apply LH rule or L'Hospital's rule. Then other case, suppose having a power is of the form 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0, 0 to the power of 0. In these cases, you can't do it directly without using log. Because first you remove the power. How to remove the power? First you take log. Once you take log, immediately you get is in the form of 0 into infinity form. Once you know that 0 into infinity form, how to convert is in the form of 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. Take product of one of the functions in the denominator, then I to immediately we get any one of this form. Then apply L'Hospital rule until we get finite or infinite value. But each and every application of LH rule, I to verify what happened present function in the corresponding limit. Okay. At the end, we get the value is log y. Our given function is y. How to find out y? Take exponential on both sides. That's the way most of the students, they're doing mistake here. Once you take log, we get the value of the given function. Suppose it takes any one of the form of 1 to the power of infinity, 0 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0, or 0 to the power of 0. Any one of these forms. Okay? Okay, fine. Then next, move to the next one. Before I move to the next one, beginning, I'd share with one slide, no? Again, I want to show that slide because that's a what I explain entire story I written in only in one slide, the entire story in only one mind, one slide. See, observe carefully. Yeah. I written here what's the indeterminate form. Suppose in 0 by 0, directly I told is possible to apply L'Hospital rule. Infinity by infinity, L'Hospital rule. But 0 into infinity can't apply. How to change it to 0 by 0? By moving one expression to the bottom. Bottom is denominator. Infinity minus infinity change to 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity by using common denominator, rationalization or factoring out of a common factor. Means taking LCM. 1 to the power of infinity, infinity power of 0, infinity power of 0, 0 to the power of infinity, take log. Log means what's the basis E to make an indeterminate product. Indeterminate product means that you convert in the form of product of product form we get in the form of indeterminate. And then how to proceed also I explain. Once you keep this slide along with you for once you take printout, I'm going to share this in the e-content notes. Keep along with you, then easy to take marks for this. How to solve the problem for indeterminate form. Suppose the given function in the corresponding limit is take indeterminate form. In that case, how to move? That's the thing I show that whatever slide. I think some those who want to pause that video, take the whatever the screenshot for that is already. I shared that now. I think you pass you move, go for previous and then you take a screenshot. Okay. Thank you very much for listening. In this class, only I'm explained what's the meaning of indeterminate form. How to find out the value of the function, suppose the function in the corresponding limit is taken in determined form, how to apply L'Hospital rule, what are the conditions that to follow to find out the value of the limit for indeterminate form using L'Hospital rule, L'Hospital's rule. Is it, I think is clear. This thing, before I'm going to wrap up my, this one, I'm going to, my class, I'm going to give one thing. Why, madam, why you need to study for the indeterminate form? Indeterminate form is very, it's one of the tool, one of the method I told is find out the value of the limit, finite or infinite value. You can't find out the finite and infinite value of the original function. This is, and also you already use this in CET entrance because you don't have a much time to find out the value of the limit using limit definition. You are a CET coach. Explain this method, crude method actually, this method, using this method, how to find out the value of the limit without spend much time. You already know that indirectly. Now we are officially, now we are knowing indeterminate form. Okay. Means finally, I'm giving a conclusion, then easy to find out the value of the limit whenever the original function corresponding to the limit, you can't find out the value of the limit. Here we are using L'Hospital rule to find out the value of the limit. That is nothing but our indeterminate form. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Again, now I'm coming back to the next class. I'm going to discuss in each cases one problem. Rest of the problem I'm going to share with my e-content notes. Okay, thank you very much. Bye, see you and take care.